swift. Mr. Swift, what are you doing? Can't you hear me?
Frankenstein, Dracula, the Wolfman, Creature from the Black Lagoon, zombies, demons, and witches, oh my. Here at Creature Features, we've shown a good deal of variants which encompass many of these famous monsters at one time or another.
We have never featured this lagoon creature.
Indeed, my good fellow. I do believe, however, that we have presented at one time or another a seafaring bug-eyed beast from a lower quality production, likely with a comically peculiar title. Yes, my dear, we know you harvest your own seaweed. But your and Livingston's continuous interruptions are derailing the carefully orchestrated tempo of my monologue. Moving onward. Welcome to Creature Features. The overly particular man on this side would be my devoted squire, Mr. Livingston, and the plankton-digesting flibbertigibbet on this side is the lovely Tangella. I, of course, am your grievously underqualified host, Vincent Van Dahl. My purpose for raising the subject of famous monsters is because tonight we'll be joined by the publisher of Famous Monsters magazine, Mr. Phil Kim. We'll be chatting about his publication, his conventions, the upcoming Silver Scream horror movie events, as well as analyzing tonight's movie, which so happens to be 1961's Werewolf in a Girl's Dormitory. With a title like that, you should have little doubt that it'll be a quality film.
It sounds dreadful.
Or deadful. So please, watch these important adverts because we'll be right back with Phil Kim and a famous monster. Yuck. Stay tuned.
This is your Mac. It's a good Mac. It does those things you like, the music that you love, and most importantly, the work that you do. Sadly though, sometimes it does this. Or this. Or this. But before you do this, try Tech Tool Pro, your one-stop fix-it tool to locate the source of this so that this still remains your things that you love, music that you enjoy, and important work that you do machine. Tech Tool Pro, the most advanced Macintosh repair utility ever.
Horror dripping into your mind, like the seconds of a time bomb into a false reality. Yet you crave the creepiest, scariest moments of this realm. These are the chilling stories from the deepest corners of the internet. Join me, your host, Spooky Boo, at www.scarystorytime.com. Get scared.
This is Livingston, and you're watching Creature Features. Not now. Stay tuned.
Hey, we're Quiet Riot here at the House of Rock in Santa Rosa, and you're watching North Bay TV, so stay tuned.
Welcome back to the show. We are joined by Mr. Phil Kim from Famous Monsters. You're like the king of the Famous Monsters now, right?
The King Ghoul, yes.
King Ghoul, you like cracked the whip.
Several monsters. Whips. It's like one of those balls at the end with one whip. So anyway, yeah.
Well, you have to because you do so many things.
Absolutely, absolutely.
You do the magazine, mm-hmm. you do the website, you do the publication, the t-shirts, you yes. do conventions.
Yes, yes.
I mean, this man does everything. And tonight, you're going to watch, what's it called? Werewolves in a Girl's Dormitory.
Yeah, absolutely.
I don't know where we got this film.
I don't either. I don't know where they got it originally.
The premise sounds amazing.
I want to watch it.
What if it was Girls in a Werewolf's Dormitory?
Yeah, maybe.
All right, well, we're going to talk some more with Mr. Phil Kim. We're going to watch this werewolf movie, and you should stick around and make some popcorn and watch the film with us, maybe. Stay with us.
Yes, who are you? What do you want?
I'm Julian Olcott. The director is expecting me. Enter, please. Thank you.
Be calm.
Wolf doesn't bother anyone.
I'm Walter, the caretaker.
I'm pleased to meet you.
The studio of the director is in front of that court at left.
Down there in front?
At the left. Give me your suitcase.
Thank you very much.
It's a pleasure for you too, isn't it, teacher?
Oh, my goodness.
Quickly, please take her to the infirmary and make room so that she can get some air.
Look, she can't even look at a new man without fainting dead away.
I'm sure she's pretending.
That one? I've known that one for a long time, way before she faked it.
Mary has a marvelous ability for always being in trouble.
Love has never killed anyone. She's just found a way to make it pay plenty for her. Beautiful.
I don't think that's the reason she did it.
Then what do you think it is? Only a man can make Mary pass out. She's bound to recover in the infirmary, so she can go out tonight.
You are Julian Olcott, sir?
Yes, I am.
I'm Leonore MacDonald.
I'm very glad to know you.
The director is expecting you.
Thank you.
Julian Olcott, correct?
Yes, that's right.
How do you do?
Pleasure. Dr. Benson told me to see you, and here I am.
Dr. Benson is an old friend. He wrote to me. I've been expecting you. Sit down, please.
Thank you. There's something I should tell you.
Please, sit down, doctor. Yes, Dr. Olcott. I know everything. Benson explained it to me. And he also said you were acting in good faith.
That's very kind of you. You know the court of law has found me to be innocent.
I know. So here you'll just be Professor Julian Olcott, and the past shall be of no importance.
Thank you. It's very good of you.
You don't have to thank me. Thank our mutual friend, Dr. Benson. I hope you'll be comfortable here. Our institute is not a house of punishment. The girls are given a chance here by the generosity of our benefactors. Without this institute, the majority of them would be in some state reformatory. We are trying to give them work and an education and put them back on the right road. No one is ill-treated here, but your job will not be an easy one.
Very good. I shall do my best because it's also important to me to find myself.
Surely, the past can become a nightmare unless we can free ourselves of it.
Sir, while I was coming here, I saw a girl who had just fainted.
Oh, that's Mary Smith. Don't be concerned because she's just coming off age.
I hope the future will be better.
Yes. But you must remember that here you are not a doctor anymore, but just a professor of science.
Of course, I won't forget.
If you come alone, I'll show you your quarters.
Ah, thank you very much.
This way, please, Professor.
The other day, the farmers had to kill two of them. The people are going mad with fear.
If I were Mary, I would be frightened.
Look there.
Mary! She means trouble, so why bother? It's better to forget her. Let her go if she wants to. Look. She sees Mary, but why doesn't she try to stop her?
She's the one who doesn't want to be seen. Funny if she had a lover.
A lover? And who could it possibly be? Maybe it's that new professor that just arrived here today.
If it is, I can understand it. He's pretty good looking.
Any man looks good to you.
You should never be here at night.
Let me go. Don't touch me, pig. You've got your money. Let me go, or tomorrow I'll spill everything about you and about him. Let me go.
Get easy, or we'll be sorry. I want you in one piece.
I came here only because of the promise you made.
Guests of the show stay at the Flamingo Conference Resort and Spa in Santa Rosa.
Experience your favorite horror, comedy, and science fiction films of the 70s, 80s, and 90s on the big screen with the Cult Film Series at Roxy 14. Double features Thursdays at 7 p.m. Visit us on Facebook for more information.
We'll be right back.
I'm Vincent, this is Tangella, and we just want to remind you we've got a wonderful website. It's at creaturefeatures.tv, and at that location we've got things like previous episodes, our merchandise, we've got photographs of the entire gang, including Tangella and her hideous friend. So be sure to come see our site. You'll love it. Welcome back to the show. We are watching Werewolf in a Girl's Dormitory with Mr. Phil Kim. Now, it's a reformatory, I think.
Reformatory?
It means the girls are naughty.
It's a werewolf movie with girls. Yes, they are.
And it's an Italian werewolf movie.
It's very naughty, yeah.
It was made in 1961.
It's really naughty.
So, you know, things are not going to be very proper.
No, no.
There might be some miniskirts. Another... bikinis. You know, the bikini was new back then.
Yeah.
All right. Enough with this for now. Phil Kim. You know, I've been trying to get this guy on the show forever. He's so busy. You've got, like, the Famous Monsters mag. You've got conventions.
Mm-hmm.
You probably have a reality show as well.
Oh, I wish. Yeah.
You should.
We actually have a TV show.
That's right. The Famous Monsters. I love that show.
Oh, thank you. I love your show.
No. But yeah. Yours, you go places.
I do, yeah.
This one, we go no place. We sit here.
This is spiritually everywhere.
Well, yeah, but it's like, you know, I just sit here and like, oh, blah, 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 movie, blah, 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 blah. And you get to like travel and meet like exciting new people in strange places. And
It's true.
Look at their things.
Yeah.
Their creations.
Yes.
So have you had fun?
It's a good time, yeah. Yeah. It's you know... This is a great old house. We and there's some predictability except for the spirits that roam around here. For us, when we're on set, you know, it's very unpredictable. So sometimes it can be fun. Lots of times it's night shoots, so it's cold.
Oh, cold is good.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness, I like it cold.
Oh, do you?
I mean, that's okay. Why we're so close to the coast.
Oh yeah.
No, you know, I don't like warm weather. You know, Britain's not a warm place.
That's so right.
It's like I acclimated.
Yeah.
And I never acclimated when I got here. But enough about me. Let's talk about you. So you do the show.
Yes.
And then you're doing the magazine, which is now a yearly.
It's an annual, yes.
An annual.
Yes. It's a big, thick, annual monster smorgasbord.
Well, that's wonderful. And what kind of monster? What's the most popular monster you cover today?
You know, it's interesting. It's the creature, always. The creature
the Black Lagoon.
From the Black Lagoon.
That's a letter. That's a mail we get all the time. Oh, show creature from the Black Lagoon.
Absolutely. Did you know that he had three movies?
The Creature from the Black Lagoon.
Mm-hmm.
Return of the Creature.
That's right.
And the Creature Dies.
Almost.
No, I don't know. Do you know?
It slips me. I'm embarrassed, but it slips me. But we're showing all three of them at the film festival.
We should Google it.
Yeah.
Have you tried it? Google? It's incredible.
They take all your information, you know.
You type, well, of course. You give it to them and you say, yeah. I would like to know how to cook rice.
Yes.
Or I would like to know how to cook spaghetti.
Yep.
And all of a sudden, it's there.
Yeah. No, it's an incredible, it's great.
I know. All right. Well, let's see some more of this movie. Mm-hmm. We're going to talk some more with Mr. Phil Kim when we come back. And stay with us. This movie is going to get better, I'm told, I think. Maybe.
Leave me alone. I came here because I want something.
What is it you want now? But I've given you everything.
And so who needs it if I have to stay walled in here? Make your promise good to get me out. You wanted a little love on the sly. Then find me a way out of this pig pen tomorrow night. Do you hear? Tomorrow night.
No, Mary. You know very well the court has sentenced you. So only the court can possibly free you, Mary.
My body for a middle-aged oversex phonier. Now you expect to get off the hook. No, you don't.
Aren't you forgetting, Mary, that you have the letters? The letters. When you give them to me, I'll free you.
They're burned. Remember, they're important proof. Very important. So careful.
No, wait. Something can be done. Wait.
You won't keep me waiting. Or tomorrow you're finished at this school.
Mary, wait. Wait. I'll think of something. Sheena. Sheena. Sheena.
You really are corrupt, Alfred.
No. It's not about her again. Not this time. It's now something horrible, Sheena.
I saw. You're a beast, not a man, my dear, so go to the devil.
I haven't done anything. I haven't done anything. I'm not with that girl anymore. It's true. She's blackmailing me. The letters. The letters. Yesterday, I wrote a letter to her that can be a disgrace to me.
You're not only thoroughly miserable, Alfred. You're without a doubt a pitiful imbecile.
But I didn't sign them, never. They can't possibly suspect they're mine.
You fool! How far do you think you would go if everyone knew what you really are, Sir Alfred Weitzman?
I know it, Sheena. You're right.
Miss Schultz, is it all right, please, to go in there? I want to see her.
No, it's not possible. Take this, distribute.
My report from the coroner. He said the girl was assaulted by wolves, and she died as a result of the injuries inflicted. But she could have had a meeting with a man a little before her death. I don't believe it could have been the wolves.
A girl who wanders out at night into the forest. And, Professor, she was alone, mind you. Not to mention the probable rendezvous with someone could very easily have been attacked by wolves.
Poor girl. It's a terrible disgrace to be destroyed after years of work. I fear that the good name of our institute will be compromised.
We can't be concerned about the institute's good name in a case like this, sir.
Here's Sir Alfred Weitzman.
Sir Alfred, something horrible has happened.
Sir Alfred, I believe you know this girl.
Yes. Yes, I believe I've seen her, of course, at some time. May I leave now, please? What has occurred has upset me very much. Excuse me.
Sir Alfred, will you join us, sir, for a minute or so, for I have to complete my report. Purely a formality, of course.
Portions of this program are brought to you by Micromat, making products that keep your Macintosh running at its best.
Welcome to the Flamingo Hotel in Northern California's beautiful Sonoma County wine country. The hotel was built in 1957 to mirror the image of the original Vegas Flamingo design. It's always been the area's favorite resort because of its amenities and its strong connection to the glamour of Hollywood and Las Vegas. The Flamingo Conference Resort and Spa offers 170 guest rooms. It includes 14 suites and executive king accommodations. From all of us at the Flamingo Hotel, we thank you and look forward to seeing you soon.
In a world where monsters terrorize the waters and the dead are walking the earth, who will save you? The third annual Silver Screen Film Festival, coming to the Roxy Stadium 14 this February 16th through the 18th. Enjoy a weekend of indie films and cult classics with the stars that made your nightmares come true. See special effects makeup demos by Walter Welsh of Face Off and YouTube sensation Ellie Max. And when night falls, wine and dine at our VIP dinners with music and entertainment, with proceeds going to the Santa Rosa Wildfires Fund. Go to silverscreenfest.com to get your tickets before it's too late.
So you know what my favorite thing to do on February 11th, 2018 is?
I'm afraid to ask.
I love to go to the East Bay Comic Con, and we shall be going. I'll be with these two nincompoops, and you should come see us. We shall be doing fun stuff like watching films and eating popcorn. Or are we going to be watching popcorn and eating films? I don't know. However, the website is right here, so you should go see the website, sign up, buy a ticket, and come see us. Right?
If you say so, sir.
Right.
You sure you don't want some? It's chamomile.
Listen, you are extremely terrifying. Just the scariest undead subhuman thing on TV, and I really mean that. But I am worried that you could give my kids nightmares if they see you, so I'm gonna have to block you. So that's it. Oh, and tell the zombies they're blocked too.
Sutherland from Power Rangers, and you're watching North Bay TV. Stay tuned.
Go, go, Power Rangers!
Welcome back to the show. Our guest had to step out for a moment to do what?
I'm not sure.
Yeah. They had to step out. So we're going to do all letters. And before we do that, Tangela, did you dig up another one? You know, I'm never going to marry you off if you keep, like, doing this. Is she digging these out of the graveyard, or is she removing them from live subjects?
I believe they're from the cemetery, sir.
That one does look rather old. All right. We'll just keep that away from my end of the house. All right, what do we got, Mr. Livingston? We've got a letter from Rich Smith Jr. He does not say where he's from, but he says, Creature Features, thanks for reviving an SF Bay Area. SF means San Francisco, right?
Indeed.
San Francisco Bay Area classic from the 70s. You're awesome. Well, thank you, Rich. You're awesome, too. By the way, you seem to have Bob Wilkins' persona down. Kudos. Ooh. I appreciate the compliment, Rich, but, you know, I've seen footage of Bob Wilkins, and he was, like, rather polite and nice and humorous, and I'm quite the opposite. Wouldn't you agree?
You can be polite and humorous when you try.
Which is not often. All right. Well, thanks for writing to us, Rich. And what we got next? This one is from David Gary?
So it would appear.
In San Anselmo, California. You know, don't they make corks in San Anselmo?
Make what?
Corks. You know, for wine bottles.
I haven't the vaguest idea.
Well, they have cork trees down in San Anselmo. That's what I heard. I read it on Wikipedia. Dear Vincent Van Dahl, this one's for me. Long time viewer, first time writer. Thanks for the best color print of Santa Claus Conquers the Martians that I've seen. We showed this film in December, right? I mean, that was
Christmas
a Santa
time,
Claus,
yes.
Right, Christmas show. And we had Santa in Tangela's chair. I guess that's a guest chair, and Tangela sits in it sometimes, right?
You and your crew
are awesome. Please give my thanks to Livingston and Tangela. Thank you, Livingston and Tangela, from David. Bob Wilkins would be proud. Well, thank you. That's quite kind of you to say, David. And our last note would be from John in Union City. And he actually wrote it that way, John in Union City. I wish you would all write like that because it makes it easier for me to find out where you're writing from. He says, hello, Vincent and pals. Pals. Well, I don't have any pals. Are you talking about these two? Well, I guess they're kind of, that's
three.
My pal. That's her pal. I really enjoy the show, and I find it to be the highest standard of standardness. Of all the horror host shows I've seen, yours is the one I saw last night. All right. My question is, if you could choose any living guest for your show, whom would it be? Thanks, John in Union City.
You know, I'm who any living guest, who would I have?
They're all living.
Well, one would hope. But I mean, maybe like Brad Pitt. And you know why? Because more people would watch the show if Brad Pitt was on it. We tried to get him to sit here for us, but he was busy. So it would probably be Brad Pitt, so people would watch it, and Tangela would like it, right? If Brad Pitt, no? She's not a Brad Pitt fan. I like him. You like him as well, don't you?
He's all right.
He's all right. All right, well, thank you, John in Union City. That's it for letters. If you'd like to send us a letter, you can email it here, or you can send it in the post here. And either way, we'll eventually see it, I think. You still read the mail, right?
I do.
Right. And it'll go through him, and hopefully it'll go to me. So stay with us. We'll be right back after the break with what? Oh, more stuff, right? More stuff. Stay with us.
Good dog. Stop it. It's a friend. I was expecting you.
Where do we have to go?
You'll see. Are you afraid of the wolves?
No.
Come on, let's go. Watch the house well, Wolf.
Quickly, we can't afford to be seen by anybody. Come on, we haven't far to go. Beasts fighting among themselves, Priscilla. Come on.
Is this where it was, Walter?
What do you mean?
Is this where they found Mary?
How would I know? Come on. He's expecting you. Go.
Don't be afraid.
You're Sheena Whiteman.
You expected to find my husband, am I right? Stop it. Take this. This is so you'll have a worthwhile reason for coming here. To me, you're another common slut, just like all the others. And as of now, it's finished between you and my husband.
Whiteman. It was your husband. Now it's clear to me.
What's clear to you, you little tart? You're all alike. You're all ready to sell yourselves.
Yes, but not to be killed. Your husband has killed Mary Smith because she received this.
No. My husband is perhaps a philanderer, but he's not an assassin.
Then I'll explain all this to the police.
I warn you, girl, you'd better not be foolish or I'll be forced to appeal to the dogs.
That wouldn't help you at all. All the other letters are securely hidden in case they find me, like my friend, attacked by the wolves.
Where are the other letters? Do you have them?
Those letters will be delivered to the police. I only want to know who's written them.
Oh, that's the reason you came here.
Yes, that's the reason, even if you don't believe me.
Sit down. I believe you, but also you must listen to me. For a long time, I've been watching my husband. He's a strange man. He's a sadist. Everyone else believes he's a respectable person. And he's not even faithful. It's true. It's true the other night he had an appointment with that Mary. I followed him, intending to interrupt them and put an end to it once and for all. They met each other, and when Alfred left her, I know that girl was alive, still living. But suddenly, there occurred something horrible. It wasn't my husband who killed your friend, and it was not the wolves. There was a moon. I saw that the assassin didn't run away immediately. He remained in almost a contortion for some moments on the bridge before going, and it was then that I was able to recognize him.
Who's there?
Where?
Over there. There was someone at the window.
Oh, it was that caretaker who brought you here.
Who do you say is the murderer?
I don't want to tell you. Not now, anyway. It's better that you keep your nose out of this filthy mess. The letters and all the rest. Also that poor girl. Her name would be covered with mud. Let her rest in peace.
But she was assassinated.
Another dirty scandal would be the final ruin of us all, and certainly wouldn't bring back to life your Mary.
Do you still love your husband?
Yes.
To the point of killing one of his lovers?
I? Why? What sort of a person do you think I am?
The dogs. You didn't say anything to them. If they'd find me killed by them, they'd believe it was the wolves.
You are really stupid. I've been foolish to confide in you.
Calm down. What are you doing here at this hour?
Maybe I should ask you the same thing.
But I can respond to that. I'm fixing traps to free the forest from the wolves.
In a certain sense, we were doing the same thing.
What do you have to tell?
Oh, nothing. Were you the one that was following me, Professor?
No. Absolutely. Why?
I don't know. It seemed like someone was following me.
Come on, I think I'd better go back with you to the Institute.
I'm certainly safer going with you than going alone.
Priscilla, I'm sorry, but I have to make a report. You were told not to come here.
Make it. You don't have to worry about me.
You're a strange girl.
Is that a compliment?
Oh, perhaps.
This is your Mac. It's a good Mac. It does those things you like, the music that you love, and most importantly, the work that you do. Sadly though, sometimes it does this. Or this. Or this. But before you do this, try Tactual Pro, your one-stop fix-it tool to locate the source of this so that this still remains your things that you love, music that you enjoy, and important work that you do machine. Tactual Pro, the most advanced Macintosh repair utility ever.
Horror dripping into your mind, like the seconds of a time bomb into a false reality. Yet you crave the creepiest, scariest moments of this realm. These are the chilling stories from the deepest corners of the internet. Join me, your host, Spooky Boo, at www.scarystorytime.com. Get scared.
Uh-huh, right, right. Oh, so it was
revenge of the creature, and the creature walks among us. Does that sound right? All right. No, thank you, love. Thank you, love. So I rang Google because my computer does not work. It's an old one. So they corrected us on that whole thing with the creature.
Great.
Right. All right. So this film, we are watching Werewolf in a Girl's Dormitory, right? Mm-hmm. With Mr. Phil Kim. Mm-hmm. And the werewolf took his first victim, killed her, and then just threw her in a river. What's up with this? At least, like, a vampire will suck the blood.
What a waste.
And, like, use it for something. And you would think a werewolf would, like, eat.
Absolutely.
I don't know. All right. Let's talk about this thing you've got going on next weekend.
Silver Scream Film and Comic Fest.
It's a play on Silver Screen.
That's right.
I couldn't understand what it meant. I thought, like, a silver scream would be like that second mouth coming out of the alien.
Yeah.
That would be like a silver scream, right? Mm-hmm. No, but this is Silver Screen Film Fest, and you've got some great guests.
We do. We have Dee Wallace, who, I mean, her IMDb credit is so long.
I love her.
Cujo, E.T., on and on and on.
The mom on E.T.
Yes, the mom on E.T. Some big roles, yeah. And then we have... Kelly Maroney, who, man, she was the cheerleader with the machine gun in Night of the Comet.
You know, I think all cheerleaders should carry machine guns.
Absolutely. It's the sexiest thing even possibly. Well, very empowering.
No, but you know, they're at a disadvantage in those short dresses. I mean, they can't fight off criminals with, you know, karate.
That's true.
So, you know, they should carry a machine gun.
Absolutely.
All right, and who else you got?
And then we have Barbara Crampton.
Now, she was in that famous movie, which...
Oh, From Beyond, and the other H.P. Lovecraft movie.
You're as bad Needles. As I am. You don't remember film names. I'm terrible. It's wonderful to finally meet somebody who cannot remember films like me.
Reanimator.
That's the one I was going to say that, and I thought I was wrong.
Well, all I remember is Maybe. Barbara Crampton. And Jeffrey Combs, so I
and
know
that's,
the names. Yeah.
Reanimated, right? No, right. he was amazing. In
he
that
was.
Film.
He's great. He was great.
And I mentioned Barbara was as well.
Yeah.
It's been so long since I don't think I've seen that film since it came out.
It's, you know, some films you're like, oh, it's really this seminal, and then you look back, you're like, wow, they really did it badly. That one you can keep watching. You know what's another one? And John Russo is going to be there for the 50th anniversary of. Night of the Living Dead. We're showing the Criterion version that's releasing this weekend.
The
that
new
weekend.
Remake.
Yeah. Yeah.
The new restoration.
Restoration. Right. Beautiful, beautiful. And John Russo, who people don't really remember, was he actually wrote at least half of Night of the Living Dead. He was George Romero's other half.
My goodness.
And then he also did, he created Return of the Living Dead with the whole brains thing. Brilliant guy. He's
well, if
be
you're
there.
Into zombies, you must attend this event.
Absolutely.
All right. Well, we're going to give you some more details about this event and more when we come back. But first, we're going to get back to this werewolf film because, I mean, if you could kill girls in the dormitory as a werewolf,
right?
You know, why not make a film about it, right?
Absolutely.
Leave it to the Italians. We'll be right back.
You're too pessimistic. Even if life is hard, it's worthwhile living it. You must believe in something. Don't be afraid. It's only a wolf that must have just fallen into one of my traps.
You have
to go?
Yes. Excuse me, it's really necessary. You know, the wolves know how to free themselves and escape with a broken foot.
Oh. Don't be worried. I'm almost there already. Professor?
Yes?
The report?
Don't worry about it. I won't say anything to anybody about it this time. I won't even ask you what you were doing out at this hour. You see, I have faith in you.
Thank you.
Priscilla.
Professor? Is it you?
Sheena was all to me. A companion both good and kind and devoted.
She was attacked by a monster, one of the girls from the Institute, and she was saved by a dog.
One of the girls saw this. She said his right arm was torn open by the dog.
The police have to inspect each and every man in these...
Absolutely.
Police are asleep here. We'll have to try and find it ourselves.
Certainly. Bronzeville will not lay down.
We'll find him.
Yes, we'd better act before he strikes again. We don't want him to get hold of one of our children.
The sheriff. Okay, talk.
She's still in the infirmary. The dresser wouldn't find anything.
You must. You have to find them. If I don't recover those letters, I cannot rest.
Look at that man. His right arm isn't functioning.
He's the caretaker of the Institute.
Sir Alfred, the girl was attacked right in the vicinity of the guardhouse.
Certainly it's him.
Come on, what are we waiting for?
Careful. Don't move.
He mustn't get out of here. He must account for what he has done.
Mr.
Stop it! You're all going mad. Let go of that knife. Walter, nobody's going to do you any harm. Now let him pass through.
The man's hand. Look, men. Look at his hand.
This man has no scar on his hand. His hand has been like this since he was born. Now we're leaving. Step aside. Come on.
Come on, go on and sit down. Nothing is happening. Get going, boys.
What were you doing with Sir Alfred?
Nothing, Dr. Sweat. Why?
Return to the Institute. These people could do you great harm.
Yes, sir.
Why are you crying? It's all in the past now. Calm yourself. Here you are protected.
Yes, yes. But it isn't that.
And what is all this?
Sheena Whiteman.
Sheena? Is this what's troubling you? Tell me why. You must have faith in me, Priscilla. You know that you can trust me.
Finally. They wouldn't even let me in here. They told me I mustn't stay long. Oh, excuse me. I'm not disturbing you.
No. I was just telling the professor how very pleased I am to see him.
Priscilla.
But at this point, it's better to say it all. Right, Professor?
Experience your favorite horror, comedy, and science fiction films of the 70s, 80s, and 90s on the big screen with the Cult Film Series at Roxy 14. Double features Thursdays at 7 p.m. Visit us on Facebook for more information.
Hearties, I'm Crazy Boots Martin.
And James the Red.
At the NorCal Pirates Festival, and you're watching North Bay TV. Stay tuned.
Guests of the show stay at the Flamingo Conference Resort and Spa in Santa Rosa.
Werewolves in a Girl's Dormitory. What a film. I kind of like it. I mean, you know, the Italians, they know how to make calls.
They're never bad. The style, yeah. Style is, that's what they are.
Spooky films. Mm-hmm. It's a spaghetti horror film. Yeah. Unlike the spaghetti western, I love them. We are here with Mr. Phil Kim, and he is like the CEO or like the Admiral of Famous Monsters.
Yes.
Admiral?
Admiral.
I like that. Good, it's got a L. Ron Hubbard effect to it.
Yeah.
So it's an amazing thing. That has been around since long before you were born.
1958, I am the third publisher.
That's amazing. Mm-hmm. And it's like, it's so famous, it's iconic.
Yes.
I mean, I could see the logo in my head.
Yes.
Without even looking at it on paper.
That's right.
That's incredible. But we're talking about Silver Scream.
That's right.
A film festival that he's operating. You know, what's your job there?
Well, it's not just me. It's with Neil Perlmutter, who
we
is
love
the,
Neil.
We love Neil. Neil is the president of the theater.
I didn't know he's president.
Yeah. He's got a pretty nice
title. I thought he was a popcorn man.
He used to be.
Oh.
You can climb the corporate ladder.
Well, from now on, I shall refer to him as Mr. President.
That's right.
Right? He deserves it. He earned that title, right?
Absolutely.
So you're doing this festival. You're going to have all kinds of famous people mm-hmm. that we mentioned at the last one. No, that's famous right. monsters, just famous people. Right?
Well, Rico Browning, who was the original creature suit actor.
He must be an old man by
he's
now.
He's turning 88. 88? His birthday is actually going to be celebrated on Friday at the reception.
My goodness. Yes. And how is he? I mean, is he all right?
He can take me on. Yeah, for sure. He is. He was a deep sea diver.
Oh.
He was an actual diver. Oh, and he also wrote and created Flipper. People don't know that. Yeah.
He wrote Flipper. That's incredible.
He created right. Flipper.
I want to hear some more about this, but I'm getting the signal. We got to get back to the movie. So you stay with us because something interesting coming up here, and you need to come see it because guess who might be there? Stay with us.
Sandy, what is it?
I must speak to you. It's something terrible.
Well, what is it? So speak.
I know who the monster is.
What's that?
Julian Alcott, the professor of science. He's a badly damaged arm.
This is not enough proof to even mention.
Mary was murdered the night of his arrival. It's him, and he's in the infirmary with Priscilla talking to
him. Don't call Professor Alcott now, and don't tell anyone what you just said to me.
But I...
Listen, if your suspicions are correct, I shall call the police. Now go ahead. Tommy, call Professor Alcott immediately.
I cannot tell you too often, but I must have those letters.
With pleasure, Sir Alfred. If the letters are still here in the Institute, I'll find them.
Good.
You wanted to see me, sir?
Yes. What, in your opinion, happened in the woods?
Well, I believe it has to do with a lycanthropus.
In other words, a sort of werewolf.
Exactly.
Please explain this to me further.
What is this? An interrogation?
Better to tell me than the police, don't you think?
Yes, of course. Well, you know of my career as a doctor. Was terminated by a tragic incident. I was working for Dr. Benson at the mental hospital for the criminally insane. There was a girl. She was accused of homicide. But the poor girl could not absolutely recall killing anyone. She seemed perfectly normal. I must add, I was in love with her.
Continue, please.
In a full moon, she would behave in a very strange way. She would lose complete control of herself and transform absolutely. And her face was like a beast's. Professionally, I wanted to try to help her.
And after a certain time, I discovered a temporary antidote. And it's so difficult, actually, without my using the medical terms to explain.
I've always been interested in medicine, and I think I could follow you.
The pituitary gland controls the function of the hormones, influencing the sexual organs and the thyroid. And as a direct reaction, it can cause a psychophysical transformation. My colleagues refuted this theory of mine, and I had proven it unequivocally. For example, at every lunar cycle, the pituitary gland acts strangely and becomes enlarged at the start of the transformation. Our psychocontrols upset the balance of the neuroglandular system, causing incredible distortions in the skin, hair, and teeth. In this state, the patient cannot be saved. I was successful with the extract of the brain of a wolf while I was experimenting on her. One night, she gave herself an overdose. Perhaps I made it too strong. And the police then accused me of killing her. Do you want to know more?
In observing the body of Murray, did you feel the crime was committed by lycanthropus?
Yes. I'm almost sure about it. I continued my studies in this matter.
And this led you to other discoveries. Is it possible to rid yourself completely?
I don't know. But that's not of importance anymore. Since I've been here, I've been trying to capture a wolf to extract his glands.
They're not rare in our forests. But tell me, Professor, have you ever experimented on yourself?
Once. I had to find out what it would be like for a normal human being. It was impossible to observe myself.
Would you mind showing me your right arm?
No, of course not. Yes, it's hurt. But I did not attack Priscilla.
A strange coincidence, don't you think? Before you arrived, there never was any talk about monsters in this town.
Then you think that I'm...
Professor, you said yourself that a person can be completely out of control during a crisis. How much does he remember afterwards?
Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Not even one sign remains of it. I assure you that this is what happens. Anyway, I must assure you of one thing. I hurt myself accidentally.
Professor, I want to believe every word of it, though it may not appear that way. But I advise you, however, to take great care. Perhaps you had better discontinue your experiment.
Absolutely not. I can't. The life of a human being may depend on it.
And who might this be?
I don't know. You asked me to tell you about a lycanthropus. His sickness must have satisfaction. In the next transformation, he'll try again.
And you believe that if you manage to find a definite antidote, you'll probably save the life of that person. Then you know who the attacker is.
Well, if I should discover an antidote, I'm sure that this person would certainly want to be helped.
Sick or not, Professor, he'll be obliged to give himself up.
I'm a doctor. It's not fair to treat a lycanthropist like a murderer. If ever I'm successful in finding a cure, these poor victims could possibly begin to lead a normal life, like others.
Perhaps you're right, if you think murder won't bother his conscience.
If you should ever find out that I am the monster, I should like to be treated the same as you would like to be.
I understand you perfectly.
Werewolf, huh? That's impossible.
This is your Mac. It's a good Mac. It does those things you like, the music that you love, and most importantly, the work that you do. Sadly though, sometimes it does this. Or this. Or this. But before you do this, try Tectool Pro, your one-stop fix-it tool to locate the source of this so that this still remains your things that you love, music that you enjoy, and important work that you do machine. Tectool Pro, the most advanced Macintosh repair utility ever.
Kids will spend 15 minutes watching online videos like this one.
Brushing for 2 minutes now can save your child from severe tooth pain later. 2 minutes twice a day. They have the time.
Hi, I'm Linda Blair, and if you want to be scared, stay tuned on North Bay Television, coming up.
Portions of this program are brought to you by Micromat, making products that keep your Macintosh running at its best.
And welcome back to the show. We've got a special treat for you. We've been getting lots of requests for this film, and even Louise in Oakland has brought it up recently. And it is a film called Bambi Meets Godzilla. And we're going to show it because it's one of Tangela's favorite films, little did I know. And you've seen it, haven't you, Livingston?
Unfortunately, I've been denied the pleasure.
Oh, well, consider it undenied now. Let's roll Bambi Meets Godzilla. Horrid. I mean, completely grotesque. Why would anybody request this?
I have no idea.
And I don't understand why that's your favorite film. You like animals so much. Oh well. It's just animation, right? So I suppose it's all right. Anyways, we'll be back after the break, and we'll be back with our guests as well. Stay with us.
Look there!
Where?
At the top of the stairs!
Stop. Walter, stop, or I'll shoot!
Girls, go back to the dormitory. This is nothing for you to see.
I said stop, or I'll shoot!
Come on,
Nothing more to do.
He was the monster. He tried to kill Sandy.
Enough of that. Miss Leonora, get them all inside.
Go on, girls, enough now. Go on inside.
Was he the monster?
Perhaps the monster never existed. Walter smothered the girl. Now, please, go on, Tommy.
I'm going to call the police.
All right.
Professor?
Priscilla.
What's happened?
Priscilla, it's terrible. Walter killed himself.
No.
It's true. We caught him by surprise fleeing from the dormitory after he tried to kill one of the girls. Sandy.
Sandy?
Yes.
So Walter was the monster?
No. He couldn't be the monster.
But why not?
Because Walter had a dog. And dogs can't stand the odor of wolves.
This is appalling, Sir Alfred.
Yes. It's like a compulsion I have here inside of me. And why am I like this? I don't know why. But I've never killed anybody. I've always paid. I've always paid for everything.
Those that seem the best sometimes commit the worst. You know you've killed Walter.
No. I only ask him to find the letters. I didn't know he'd be foolish enough to risk his life. You must help me.
By helping you, Miss Leonora and I were almost involved in this dirty scandal. If Miss Leonora and I had not discovered the letters, you would be in jail.
I'm innocent. Oh, if only Sheena were still alive.
But why?
Because Sheena, that night, when Mary was killed, she followed me. She saw who it was.
Don't invent these absurd stories. There's no need for it. I have no intention of denouncing you.
I haven't had a moment of peace since Sheena died. It's as if I had killed her with my own hands. If only I had the courage to kill myself. But Sheena knew. She knew.
If she knew, why didn't she speak up?
I don't know. Maybe she kept silent. To blackmail me. She said that with one word, she could send me to the gallows.
Even the death of your own wife looks strange in the light of this story.
Strange? You think that I...
I'm not thinking anything. What are you going to do?
What will you do? If you destroy me, you destroy yourself as well.
Go, Sir Alfred.
Why didn't you tell me about Sir Alfred?
Because I was afraid. I don't know much about you, Julian. You continue to have secrets. Julian, I know you're a medical doctor.
Ah. Well, then. You must also know that I'm a failure.
Julian, is one mistake really so bad?
Oh, no. But it's a battle, Priscilla. One cannot forget the past when it keeps following you. All right, let's go. There are more important things to be done now.
Experience your favorite horror, comedy, and science fiction films of the 70s, 80s, and 90s on the big screen with the Cult Film Series at Roxy 14. Double features Thursdays at 7 p.m. Visit us on Facebook for more information.
Bostwick, you're watching North Bay TV. Buy my underwear.
Awesome. Huh?
And welcome back to the show. We are still watching Werewolf in a Girl's Dormitory. Mm. Wow. Hey, you know, I'm having difficulty remembering the name of this film.
Really?
It's so long. I mean, it's not like Jaws, which has four letters. I mean, that's easy for me to remember.
But
this
Werewolf and Dormitory and Girls, I mean.
I know, but it's so specific.
And it's the order.
Let's talk about your stuff, yes. Mr. Phil Kim. Mm-hmm. The Scream Fest.
Yes.
I am completely intrigued by this, and you know why? I'm going to be there.
That's right.
No, we're going to have, I think Tangella and Livingston will be there as well.
I'm excited, honestly.
I'm excited because, you know, I went to the first one.
Mm.
And I just popped in for a moment and just took a peek around. It was exciting. You had Robert Englund.
Yep.
Freddy Krueger.
Yep. Phantom.
And right. I got like this far.
Oh.
From Freddy Krueger. And it frightened me.
No.
It did. You know, he does not look quite the same in his normal street face.
No.
But you could still see it in his eyes now, mm-hmm. Can't you?
The crazy?
Right. So this event is next weekend.
That's right.
At the theater. It's called what?
The Roxy 14. It's a stadium theater.
Roxy 14 in Santa Rosa.
Santa Rosa. Right. Yep.
So we'll have to drive into town for that, and it'll be worth it.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And it's next weekend, and it's 3 days.
It is 3 days.
Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
Friday, it starts at 5 p.m. on Friday, and it ends 5 p.m. on Sunday.
And Saturday night is the big gala.
The gala, it's for the fire relief, And
it's a benefit.
It's a benefit.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, see, you need to come to the gala, and that's like a special ticket thing.
Yeah, it is a special ticket thing, and the proceeds goes to the Fire Relief Fund, and also we will have comedians, we will have you, and we will have music, and we will have celebrities there. So it's I'm looking forward to that.
The only thing you'll be missing is a swimming pool. Oh, wait, Flamingo has a swimming pool.
That's right.
Hey, we got it covered. All right, so is there a specific website for this event?
Yes, it's www.silverscreamfest.com.
So www.silverscreamfest.com. No dashes or anything like that?
No. .com.
.com.
Yep.
There you go.
Yep.
So visit the website, and we want to see you next weekend because it's going to be fun.
That's right.
Right, Phil?
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, let's get back to this film.
Yep.
Off we go. The end of Werewolves in a Girl's Dormitory on Creature Features.
Yep.
See you soon.
Excuse us, Sir Alfred, but it's very important that we see you.
I'm sorry, but I don't have a lot of time to give you. Please.
Sir Alfred, I have a very delicate question to ask you. Let me assure you, I will tell no one of this visit.
But I don't understand, Professor Olcott. I have nothing to hide.
You're in bad trouble because of your relations with Mary Smith.
How dare you, sir?
The letters. Sir Alfred, that is not the point. I want to know exactly what happened that night you met with Mary in the woods.
Professor, are you accusing me? Do you have any proof?
I didn't say that. But I wondered if you'd come with me to the police.
The police?
Yes. I don't doubt your innocence. But there are some facts that have to be cleared up.
I don't have to defend myself. You're crazy if you think that
you
I
had... Believe me, don't worry. We don't want a scandal. I know. The facts are all against you right now. But if you have nothing to hide, why are you afraid?
All right. Perhaps I was wrong. So we had a relationship, but that's all there was to it. There's no reason to believe that I would murder her. Excuse me, will you, woman, please? I'll go get the letters, and you can see for yourself.
Well, what about him?
It's a possibility.
Thank you. It's necessary to have a second injection.
I know.
Oh, darling, please, let us finish the cure now.
No. Better that you leave me like this. I wish that you hadn't been late that night.
I arrived too late. Probably at that moment, Mary was escaping in the woods and might well have seen me come here.
Don't have remorse now.
You don't know what I've done.
Leonore, you're thinking about Sheena Whiteman.
How did you know that?
Sir Alfred told me that Sheena knew who Mary's murderer was.
I was so frightened. Sheena and Priscilla saw each other in the forest. I saw it through the window. Sheena must have seen you kill Mary that night. You must know I was forced to do it.
And she recognized me.
Yes.
Oh, all the bad I've done.
But we must fight back to save you, because without you, I don't exist.
Leonore, the second injection. You know I'm not a murderer.
Don't! Leonore! Get away from her! Get away from her! Leonore! I can't help you, Leonore! Get away from her, you filthy beast! Get away! Get away from her! Leonore! I can't help you! Get away! Leonore! Leonore! My darling! The key, Leonore.
You began.
world is obsessed with origin stories. What's your story?
So you know what my favorite thing to do on February 11th, 2018 is?
I'm afraid to ask.
I love to go to the East Bay Comic Con, and we shall be going. I'll be with these two nincompoops, and you should come see us. We shall be doing fun stuff like watching films and eating popcorn. Or are we going to be watching popcorn and eating films? I don't know. However, the website is right here, so you should go see the website, sign up, buy a ticket, and come see us. Right?
If you say so, sir.
Right.
A single ember from a wildfire can travel over a mile. You can't control where it will land, only what happens before it does. Visit fireadapted.org to learn how to protect your community from wildfires.
You're watching North Bay TV, so stay tuned.
That night in the guardhouse.
So what? And now?
Listen to that story. Tell us, Pris, is it because you're making time with a professor that you're being so very uppity about it?
Don't listen to her, please.
Miss Leonor will not be with you this morning. She had to leave for reasons of her own. You may stay in the park this morning, and tomorrow you'll attend the funeral of Walter. Silence! You have no right to judge others, much less when they are dead. Judgment is for God alone.
After all, he got what he deserved.
No! Get away! Get away from here!
The death of his master might have affected him. A beast sometimes is especially sensitive.
It's true. Perhaps he feels guilty of Walter's death. I'm going now.
taking me?
What have you seen?
I've seen a corpse. It's Walter.
What are you saying to me? You're imagining things.
No, I've seen it. It's not my imagination. The dog led me to it. Wolf.
A dog?
I followed him and he took me into the woods. At a certain place he began to dig and uncovered something. It was Walter.
You're still in shock from that night. Come inside. I'll get you something to drink. All right, I'll go and phone the police. But if we find nothing again this time, come in.
But if the body of Walter is buried in the woods, who could be buried in the cemetery? Mr. Swift. Mr. Swift, what are you doing? Can't you hear me?
Leonor.
killed again.
You haven't killed Priscilla. I shot you. I had to.
It's better this way. Without Leonore, I don't want to live. She was with me always.
Murdered Mary Smith in the woods. That excites
you. I went out and killed her. I don't remember. I hoped it could be cured. I followed your research. I begged Benson to send you. Leonore is in Walter's grave. Is she? We buried in the cemetery. May God forgive me.
Well, now it's finished.
It was a nightmare for me.
I know. Now the nightmare has passed.
And so ends Werewolf in a Girl's Dormitory, and our director, Evan, just had to add his own little bit of input on that. He's really good at that.
He is.
I mean, I think he should, like, move to Hollywood and be a professional werewolf sound maker.
Maybe.
No, don't do that, because we need you here. Right. So the film, you know, it ended with, he was a nice guy after all, and he dies. It was kind of sad, but, you know, I like this film.
Mm.
I mean, it was all right compared to some other films we show.
That's true.
We've shown some bad ones. And we don't intend that. It's not like we're Mystery Science Theater and we're looking for the bad ones. It's like all we can get sometimes. Anyways, enough of that. Mm-hmm. So one thing I understand about you, Mr. Phil Kim, is that you throw one of the best Halloween parties in the world.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
I mean, you have, like, the whole San Jose Convention Center.
I mean, sometimes we have the whole convention center. Other times it's a smaller party. But every year we do a Halloween something, and it's always the best. Yeah.
Well, the mere fact that you require a convention center at all, whether it's a portion or all of it.
That's right. That's
signifies
right.
to me that you are quite serious about
Halloween. Yes. We are very serious about Halloween. You know, I kind of feel like Jack Skeleton, except not as famous.
Oh, yeah, do you put on the costume?
Year-round Halloween.
You know?
Year-round.
It should be year-round, shouldn't it?
Absolutely.
You know, I always wanted to do a Halloween event that was halfway between Halloween, sort of like a summer Halloween.
Yeah, yeah.
Because people love to dress up.
Absolutely.
I think we could do it.
Yeah.
It's always Halloween here. Every time.
Absolutely.
All right, well, Mr. Phil, I want to thank you for joining us and watching this not-so-wonderful film with us.
Okay.
And tell us about Silver Scream. I'm so looking forward to doing the panel and
absolutely.
Talking with folks and meeting some of these famous people that you're
mm-hmm.
bringing.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's going to be a fun event.
But, absolutely.
Again, thank you. We hope we can have you again.
Are you coming to the VIP dinner?
I don't know. I was not invited.
You're invited.
All right. Well, off I go to the VIP dinner. I do eat sometime.
Yeah.
I'm sure there'll be good food if it says VIP.
Yes.
Well, that'd be wonderful. They'll feed me as well. Who'd have thought? All right. Well, that's it for this episode of Creature Features. We will see you next week, and we'll have something different to talk about. Maybe we'll talk about this event. But in any case, we'll see you next time, and you have a wonderful weekend. So, Phil, you know, I'm thinking, if I'm going to be at this VIP party, I mean, I imagine you might need a master of ceremonies of some kind. What about me?
Yeah, sure.